Hello students, I hope you are fine and safe at home. I am your computer teacher. Today we will start from lesson number 1, History of Computing. So take out your books and let's start. Students, in this lesson we are going to study about history of computer. As technology becomes more advanced, machines become more efficient, faster, with a better design. Do you remember the telephones from year ago? They were big and difficult to us. Over the years, better technology was developed, and we saw wireless phones, mobiles that let us talk face to face. In the same way, computers have also evolved in their functions as well as their looks. Computers today, like the ones you see at home or at school, are light, compact and fast. But this wasn't always the case. When we talk about the history of computer, we must start from the basic computing machines that people invented in order to help them with mathematical calculations. The history of computing goes long back, where the Sumerians used a box of stones as a device for representing numbers. The word computing means calculating an answer or sum. It also means the study and use of computing in today's world. Children's first is abacus. 3000 years ago, the abacus is the oldest known device used for computing. It was the first used by the Chinese about 3000 years ago. The abacus is a wooden frame with sliding beads on rods. The beads are arranged on the two sides of a crossbar. The beads are moved to calculate. It was used to perform addition and subtractions easily and speedily. The abacus is still used for counting in Japan, Korea and China. Second is Napier's bones in 1614. As necessary, demanded scientists started inventing better calculations devices. John Napier invented a system of movable rods that could be used to multiply, divide and do other calculations. It had 11 rods with 4 faces each. The device was made from bones and was called Napier's rod or Napier's bones. Third is Pascaline in 1642. In the year 1642, Blaise Pascal, a French scientist, invented an adding machine called Pascaline or Pascal calculator, which represents the position of the digit with the help of beads in it. Fourth is Difference engine in 1822. Charles Babbage designed his first computer in 1822. It was a mechanical device that could carry out repeated additions. He gave up the machine to go to develop the analytical engine. Students, fifth is Analytical engine in 1833-34. Charles Babbage was a scientist from England. Charles Babbage is called the father of a computer. Charles Babbage carried work on the analytical engine in 1834 and worked on it until his death in 1871. The design included The four basic components found in every modern computer, that is the components for performing the basic functions of input, output, processing, storage. So this machine is said to be the first generation computer. Okay, sixth is tabulating machine in 1887. In 1887, Hermann Hollerith developed a tabulating machine that could count quickly. He used punch card from storing data, which was an idea of Charles Babbage. Hermann Hollerith went on to form the tabulating machine company, which later became IBM. Seventh is ENIAC, ENIAC, in 1946. ENIAC, or Electronic Numerical Integrator and Calculator, was completed in 1945. It was developed by W. Motley and J. Presper Eckert. ENIAC is the first multipurpose digital computer. Computers have come a long way since the ENIAC to a laptop today can do 5 million additions per second. UNIVAC. The UNIVAC was a successor to the first general purpose electronic computer. The UNIVAC that is first generation computer. It was also designed by John Presper Eckert Jr. and John Motley. Okay, students, I hope that you have understood what I taught you today. Now, let us see a video to get more information.
Me, and this is my friend Clico.
Hi, everybody.
We are here to help you learn about computers. History of computers, we have to go back to the days when people used the abacus to calculate complex sums.
The abacus? Do you mean the abacus that we have used during our kindergarten days?
Yes, Reni. The instrument that you used to calculate sums during the first day at school. The abacus is probably the first counting device. It was invented about 5,000 years ago in China.
Tell me more about the abacus.
The abacus was the first mechanical device for calculation, which could also perform arithmetical calculations. Do you remember what an abacus looked like, Reni?
Yes. It is made of a wooden frame with rods, each having beads.
That's right. Counting on the abacus can be done by sliding these beads across the rods. The rods are divided into two parts. The upper part was known as heaven, and the lower part was known as earth. Let us now discuss about the Pascaline.
The Pascaline? What is it, Tico?
The Pascaline is the first mechanical calculator in the world.
Why is it called Pascaline?
The Pascaline was invented by a French mathematician called Louis Pascal in 1642, and so it is named after him.
How does it work?
The device is made up of wheels and gears. It could handle decimal values by rotating a wheel from 1 to 9 steps. It is used for adding numbers quickly. The meters used in taxis nowadays are an example of Pascaline. Do you know who is called the father of the computer?
No, Clico.
Charles Babbage is known as the father of the computer.
Who was Charles Babbage?
Charles Babbage was a British mathematician who designed the analytical engine in 1833. Charles Babbage is the person who introduced the idea of storing and reading the information before processing. All modern computers are based on this concept.
The analytical engine?
The analytical engine is an engine powered by a huge steam engine. It can handle a large amount of data and process them at high speed. Let us now discuss about the tabulating machine.
The tabulating machine?
Yes, in 1890, Hermann Hollerith, an American statistician, invented a machine called the tabulating machine.
What does that machine do?
The tabulating machine is capable of reading data, processing it, and giving the desired output. It is based on IPO or input, processing and output cycle. This machine is capable of reading both numbers and letters. Let me now tell you about ENIAC and UNIVAC.
What are these, Clicquot?
ENIAC stands for Electronic Numerical Integrator and Calculator. This machine was designed in 1946 by two American scientists called John W. Mosley and John Presper Eckert.
How was the ENIAC different from the earlier machines?
Unlike the earlier machine, the ENIAC used decimal digits instead of binary digits. The ENIAC was the first high-speed electronic digital computer, or EDC.
What about the UNIVAC?
In 1951, Mosley and Eckert developed the UNIVAC 1. It stands for Universal Automatic Computer. The UNIVAC was the first commercial electronic computer. It could work with both numerical and textual data.
Students, did you understood the video about history of computing? Okay, let's summarize the topic. The abacus is a wooden frame with beads. It is the oldest known counting device. John Napier's movable rods could be used to multiply, divide, and carry out other calculations. Blaise Pascal built an adding machine called the Pascaline. It is could be used to add up to 8 digits. Charles Babbage built a mechanical computer in 1822. It could perform repeated additions. Babbage also designed the analytical engine in 1833-34. This was the first computer developed. ENIAC was developed by W. Mosley and J. Presper Eckert in 1946. ENIAC was the first multi-purpose digital computer. Children, I have sent exercise which you need to open by clicking on the blue link of exercise. If you have the computer textbook, then write exercise in it. And if you don't have, you can write in notebook. Children, you also need to solve the MCQ test. Bye all of you. Stay safe at home. Thank you.